Hey there, and welcome back to our Final Cut Pro tutorial series. Today, we're going to be focusing on one of the most crucial steps in video editing, which is importing media into Final Cut Pro. In this video, we'll be covering everything you need to know about importing media into Final Cut Pro, including the different import methods, media location, and so let's dive in and explore the different import method options available in Final Cut Pro. For this class, I'm going to create a brand new library. If you already have a library in Final Cut Pro, you can use that, or you can just follow along. I'm going to go into File, New, Library, Import, and Organize. All right, now we have a library. I also have an event here. Events are like folders. If you want to know more about libraries and how to create them, I have another tutorial. I'll put the link in the description, or at the end of the video, you can take a look at those boxes. To make things simple, events are like folders. In Final Cut Pro software, we call them events. In other softwares, you might call them bins or folders. For the sake of this tutorial, I'm going to call this events. Let's import some media into Final Cut Pro. It's very easy. Click on the event or the folder that you want to drag media into, then click on the media that you have anywhere on your computer or any external hard drive. Just drag and drop it here, and then the media will be inside your Final Cut Pro. It's also very important to know where this media is situated, so you can always click right-click on this and reveal in Finder, and it'll actually show you the location of this media. Now that you have media inside Final Cut Pro, you can start working on it. But before we actually move forward, I want you to go into Final Cut Pro Preferences. And here, we're going to look into Import tab. Now here, these are my settings. I will encourage you to follow these settings. If you have some boxes checked, uncheck them and just follow along. Now here, we have Files option. What I have chosen as default is whenever I drag media into my Final Cut Pro browser, it will leave the files in its place. It will not copy. So it will just essentially, what it's doing is it's creating an access link to this file anywhere on my computer or my third external hard drive. Let's remove this and move it to trash. Remember, when I do that, I'm only removing the access from here. I'm not removing the original media. I'm going to go back into my preferences and click on copy to library storage location. Let's drag media again and see what it does. When I do that, you won't see a lot of difference in how it's appearing here, but what Final Cut Pro is essentially doing is it's copying this media in the background to the folder. So I can always right click this, reveal in Finder, and you can see that this media is now not on my desktop, but it's inside my library folder. Remember, we made our library import and organize, and we also have an event in there, and then we have original media and the media itself. It has copied this inside this library folder. It's easy to know where your library is. You can always right click on this and reveal in Finder, and this is where your library is situated. And if you want to know what's inside your library, you can right click, show package content, and then you can actually see that we have our event, which is here. You can rename this event if you want, and the name will change automatically here. And you have original media, and you have this. Now, this is a great option if you do not want to go through a lot of managing media stuff. Final Cut Pro will do that automatically for you in the background. This is a method that I prefer, but keep in mind, the larger your media file size are, the larger the size of this library would get. So let's say if I right click now and reveal my library, and the size here is 102 megabytes only. Now, this is the size that will expand depending on how much media you copy into your library. So keep that in mind when you're actually choosing the option of leaving media inside your library, or copying media inside a library. I'm going to delete this. It's going to delete this from my library folder itself, so the media does not exist. So if you did not copy that media elsewhere, there's no backup. This media is gone forever. There are other import options as well. I can click on this button, import media. It will bring about the import dialog box. I can also click on this icon here, this button, and it'll bring that for me. And I can also use keyboard shortcut command plus I, and it'll bring up this pop-up. It does not matter what your default settings are, you can always override them here. So for the sake of this example, I'm gonna look for this video, which is winding MOV, and here you can choose which event you want to put this media in. So maybe you have multiple folders, you went to many different locations and you created different events for that. So you can have the same event where you want to put it in, or you can create a brand new event. Final Cut Pro defaults it to the date that you're creating the event. You can always change that, or you can create a new event name. So I'm just going to add it to my event here for the sake of this class. And this is the media that I want to bring in. Now it says copy to library or leave files in its place. So here I can make a very solid decision that I want to leave these files in its place like that. And now I can continue working on these files. But sometimes what will happen is that maybe you were working on your project and you did not realize that you using this media and you deleted this media somewhere, or maybe moved this media. Final Cut Pro will not be able to access this media. Let me show you how that actually works. I have this in my media browser and you can see it's also available on my desktop. Sometimes by mistake, maybe what you'll do is you will move media around the computer or maybe delete that media like this. I'm moving it to my external hard drive. And what will happen is that Final Cut Pro will lose access to that location of that file because it was supposed to be here. And if you don't know where this media is, you are in trouble, but don't worry, Final Cut Pro can help you out with that as well. And click on the media that is missing and then go to Files and Relink and Original Media. And click on the media, locate selected. And what Final Cut Pro will do is it will open up different locations. Now I know that I put it in my external hard drive, and this is the media that is here. I can choose this, and Final Cut Pro will relink this media for me, and I'm able to actually work on this. There is another way, however, you can actually copy media if it's not already copied into your Final Cut Pro library. You have the option to do that. For that, let's click on Import and Organize. And here we have an option called Consolidate. When I click on that, it is asking me original media, and I am saving that in library, which is import and organize. When I click on this, what it's essentially going to do is it's going to copy the media in the background into my Final Cut Pro library. So now I can right click, reveal in Finder, and now you can see that this media has been copied in here, and also this media is available in my external drive. This is one more way of making sure that your media doesn't lose access, or maybe you want to get more organized. This is a method that you can actually use. And that's it for our tutorial on importing media into Final Cut Pro. We hope you found this video informative and helpful in your video editing journey. Producing these videos take up a lot of time and effort. Show your support by hitting the like button. And if you want to stick around and watch more videos and future content, make sure you hit the subscribe button. I'll see you in the next one. Take good care of yourself.